many. Thank you.
Yeah, do you need for anyone else that's going to be here?
Oh, this is really nice. Very good concept.
With the,
yeah, together.
Yeah, so convenient.
Where do you get this from?
I think they get them online. I've seen them there. You can buy them online. Yeah.
Who's teaching, preaching?
Don't know. I should check the rundown.
You just didn't mention anything.
Oh, didn't mention.
So I assume there's no...
Is it already started? Already started?
From the United States. I got 500 of those for...
How much is it?
I got 500 of these for $76. But we have these in Singapore too. I actually like the biscuits they have in Singapore better. They're slightly bigger. But
in
I just...
Oh, well.
You know, let me ask the church secretary who always orders them where she gets them from.
Oh, okay.
Because
my church, we always get into trouble with suddenly this out because it's few different congregations sharing the same building.
Yeah.
So I like this.
The nice thing is you use it, you throw away.
Absolutely, yeah.
You don't have to, nothing to wash.
I ask around, everyone say, just get it from online. So
you can't buy it online. It is more expensive in Malaysia, but I think Singapore might be cheaper.
I'll find Singapore website then.
Okay. But yes. That was...
Morning.
last sense yours, almost there.
Oh, all right.
Almost there. I said almost finished. Last session.
You can feel free to change the background.
Okay.
The last one is the cross, so I think it's a future.
I wish they can be a bit bigger. Huh?
Can. Everything can be arranged. We can go bigger. But sometimes we want it smaller so that you can,
you can see
click
all the,
faster.
Yeah. You need to put out a photo.
As we are coming into the hall, some of us will have received the communion emblems. If you're not sure what it is, it's for communion. So please do not open the packet yet. Please keep it. And then at the time when we are partaking of it together, we will open it and take it together. So please do not throw it away or keep it somewhere, but keep it somewhere safe so that we can take our communion together. And let someone else know when they come in. You see someone opening the packet and wanting to drink or eat the stuff in there, just let them know that it's fully convenient. Those of you who are helping to pass the convenient emblems, please remind our delegates. Thank you.
Screen, so that's why this machine is.
It's I sent you, right?
Yeah, that
Samsung J7. I think so. I don't know actually. I haven't seen the phone. She just told me J7 is full, but it's
okay.
Gold color, Master Osborne. Take a gold color one.
This is gold color. This is gold color. I have the same phone. Yeah. Many years ago. It's a old phone. Sometimes our finger is too fat, huh?
Yeah.
So it's not accurate.
It's not accurate. Yeah, I don't think this. No.
You understand what I'm trying to say? Yeah.
There's a time to explore things. Not now.
we all gather and we'll start in exactly a minute. We all gather and we see it. Those who are not here, those who are outside, please come in and grab a seat.
Again?
Oh yeah, you will repeat.
Fuck it.
Oh, sorry.
No, go to another slide.
Can we just put it?
Yes, of course.
ECFC. Come on, can we all do better? It's the last day, everyone's excited to go back, right? Alright, good morning. Are you ready to praise God?
Yes.
Are you ready to worship God?
Yes.
Come on, let's rise to our feet this morning and say, with God, nothing is impossible. Amen? I'm
kitchen where there was pineapple, cucumber, and bean sprouts, and jicama, and Chinese coolers, and just some lachan, and chili, and lime, and all these wonderful flavors. And what God does is he takes a little bit of each of them, and he throws them into the bowl, and he mixes them up, and he makes this amazing group that's us. But as I was worshiping, God just gave me this picture of there's some ingredients missing. And we don't have enough of some ingredients. Maybe we don't have enough lachan, shrimp paste for those of you that don't know what that is. Maybe we don't have enough chili. And so my challenge to you is, as God was showing that to me, is who's missing? Who's missing from your nation? What people are missing here? What nations that surround you are here? What's missing from our old rojak? We want to make sure that every ingredient is in the right proportion and is in our bowl, so that as we gather together, we can be that sweet, fragrant aroma of the Lord.
Amen. You may be seated. We're going to have a few moments, and just in case some of the other nations are wondering, I will translate the Bahasa. Rojak is a concoction of different local fruits put together, and then, you know, mix up with different sauces to kind of like give it. It's like a salad. It's a local salad. So just translating the Bahasa of my Western friend. it's a local dish found in these regions. As we come together for our last session this morning, the closing session, we will soon be all going our own ways to our nations. So we thought it would be good for us to take a few moments to be reminded of the unity that we have in spite of the boundaries, in spite of the borders, in spite of the distance that may separate us physically. And yet, we want to remind ourselves about the unity that we have in our hearts, in the body of Christ. The unity that transcends all these borders, and to reaffirm the unity of our hearts through the partaking of the Holy Communion together this morning. And as members of the newly appointed Executive Committee of ECFC, we will be, the four of us from the four regions, will be ministering the Holy Communion together. And Pastor Timothy will come in a short while to minister the bread, followed by Pastor Lim from South Korea, who will be ministering the wine. Pastor Leslie will then, as the re-elected chairman of ECFC for another 2 years. Last night we decided he's going to be the chairman. So let's give thanks to God that he is willing to lead us for another 2 years. And he will pray for us and follow with an exhortation before we all leave to our respective nations. We have already passed the communion emblems. If you have not received the emblems yet, would you kindly raise your hands so that someone can... So there are a few more. Can we bring the communion emblems? Do we have some more? Please keep your hands up so that they can bring it to you. Some over here. Any more? Anybody else has not received? It's that little cup that you received this morning with the bread in it. And while the emblems are being passed, I would like to encourage us to turn our Bibles to Ephesians chapter 4. And this, in some sense, speaks about the unity in the rojak that we were talking about this morning. Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 to 6. I'm reading from the New King James Version first. It says here, Paul says, I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord. I believe most of us know that this is one of the prison episodes. Beseech you to walk worthy of the calling with which you were called, with all lowliness and gentleness, with long suffering, bearing with one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body in which we are about to partake in a short while. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all, and the best news is, and in you all. isn't that the picture of what we see here in our gathering in ECFC? We come from different nations, different tribes, different cultures, different tongues, different languages, and yet we come together and we celebrate that diversity. And that can only happen in the body of Christ. I think one of the most powerful things that we saw was last night during cultural night. And I believe that most of us may not might not have fully grasped the significance of the three nations from the Indian subcontinent that came up here together. Did you notice that? The team from India, from Pakistan, and Bangladesh. Now these are, if we're speaking politically, these are warring nations. They are almost at times have positioned their armies. I think even right now, they have guns pointed at each other at the borders of each other's nation. And yet last night, we saw the brothers from these three nations come up here and present a song together. Now there's something worth celebrating. Wouldn't you say? There's something worth celebrating here. And that's just a picture of the general body of what ECFC is all about. It was a display of the body which is made possible due to only one reason. We are one body. And this is something that we cannot explain. We cannot explain. We do not understand why we are drawn to each other. We cannot explain this. We cannot reason. There's no reason for it. If we talk about reasoning, there's no reason for us to draw to each other. But yet we all want to be here. There's nothing that we can feel, sometimes even with our natural senses. It was a display that no matter how strong our flesh is, get this, how strong our reasoning is, how strong our feelings are sometimes against one another or one another's cultures or even politics, whatever these reasons may be, it still cannot resist the love that has already been placed in our hearts through the death of Jesus Christ on the cross. It cannot resist it, and that's why there's no reason for it. We're just drawn to each other. We just want to love each other. And ECFC is one of those places where we come together and my only sensation or feeling that I get whenever I come to ECFC is I get so affirmed. I get so affirmed. And I believe that each and every one of you here, everyone is so affirming. Everyone is so loving. Everyone is so encouraging. And that's, you know, that's just one picture that we saw from the Indian subcontinent. And I'm sure that there's so much more that went on behind the scenes. You know, that so many teams came up in unity. And I was talking even behind at the back with Pastor Tim from Perth. And I said, maybe the next ECFC, Malaysia and Singapore should present together. Yes, because we are one people group, all right? Just coming together, and then seeing Australia, East and West Australia coming together. That was amazing to see one Australia, one Indonesia, one Philippines, one Sri Lanka. Although, why do we do that? There's no reason, all right? Our mind tells us there's no reason. Maybe some of us, our minds may even still be battling the reasons as to why that happened. But let me tell you this, nothing can resist the love of Christ that is already in place in our hearts. If we will just allow the Holy Spirit to keep the unity of the Spirit, the Bible says to endeavor to keep the unity of the Spirit. And how do we do that? We just allow the Holy Spirit to speak to us and to teach us and to instruct us and to humble us and to put patience in our hearts towards one another. If we will allow Him to do that, we will eventually see. The Bible says, until we arrive in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11 onwards, if we will keep that unity of the Spirit, we will arrive at the unity of the faith, where we begin to walk by faith and not by sight towards one another. You know, the Message Bible says it very, very interesting, and some of us might be familiar with this Message Bible. It says it, in light of all this, here's what I want you to do, Paul says. This is a contemporary English language. While I'm locked up here, a prisoner for the master, right? I want you to get out there and walk. Better yet, run. On the road, God has called you to travel, ECFC family. I don't want any of you sitting around on your hands. I'm tempted to say, it almost sounds like Pastor Ted Albrecht speaking here. Don't sit around on your hands. I don't want anyone strolling off down some path that goes nowhere. And mark that you do this with humility and discipline. Not in fits and starts, but steadily pouring yourselves out for each other in acts of love. Isn't that what we've been doing this last couple of days? Not in fits and starts, but steadily pouring ourselves out for each other in acts of love. Let's continue that as we depart from here and go back to our nations. I like this, where he says, alert at noticing the differences. Aren't we different here? Alert at noticing the differences and yet quick at mending fences. Alert at noticing the differences. Let's say that together. Alert at noticing differences and yet quick at mending fences. Quick at mending fences. And you were called to travel on that same road and in that same direction. No matter what color we are, no matter where we come from, we are called to travel on that same road, the same direction. So stay together, both outwardly and inwardly. For you have one master, one faith, one baptism, one God, and Father of all, who rules over all, works through all, and is present. Everything you are and think and do is permeated with oneness. Permeated with oneness through the love of Christ. You know, the opposite is actually quite frightening. If we do not do that, then what will happen is, instead of running, we will be walking. And worse still, we will be sitting around in our hands. And we will be strolling off down some path that leads to nowhere. The converse is really, really frightening if we do not continue on in this path of unity. It's so important. Instead of saying, should I, pray about coming again for the next ECFC? I believe the word of the Lord that has been given by Pastor Joyce is, who else can I bring? Which other tribe can I bring? Which other nation can I bring? Which other people group can I bring to this gathering of diverse cultures and celebrate the diversity and the culture that is before our Lord? I'm going to invite Pastor Timothy Tipita. Is Pastor Timothy here? Come and to minister the bread, followed by Reverend Dr. Lim from South Korea, will minister the wine.
I think you have the bread with you. We will take it together. Pastor Simmons already given us a glimpse of the word and the bread that was broken. Jesus, as we just about to take, just hold it together and think of what Jesus did on the cross. We are here in this ECFC gathering. It's because of what Jesus did. Jesus took his disciples on side and he said, and on the table he said, he took the bread and gave thanks, broke it, gave it to them, saying, this is my body given to you. Do this in remembrance of me. he was willing. Willing. Even in the Garden of Gethsemane, he prayed and said, this is the day and the price that I must pay. He was willing, even in the Garden of Gethsemane. We think of the cross when he was hanging. We think of the stripes, the wounds, the lashes, 39 in lashes, the scribes in Isaiah. It was because of me. It was because of the world. This day, we want to say, Lord, we take this bread. We remember that you are the bread of life. You fed our soul. You nourish our hearts. You gave us the strength to run an extra mile. It's because of you paid that price. As we break this bread, we feel the softness of your love for us. We smell the fragrance of the grace you release afresh each day for us. We thank you with all our hearts for the great price you paid when you were crushed, when you crucified on the cross for us. Yet, just as the yeast has caused this bread to rise, you rose again in triumph over death as the Lord of Lords, King of Kings, forever, and our beloved Savior. We declare you are still our Lord in our life, in our family, in our homes, in our nations, even our neighboring nations. We declare, as we take this bread together, we declare, you are our Lord, and you are our King of Kings, Lord of Lords. We declare, and we take it together, in Jesus' name. Amen.
이전에 피로 세운 새 언약이니 이것을 행하여 마실 때마다 나를 기념하라 하신 주님, 우리가 이 잔을 듭니다.
The Lord said, "This cup is new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Lord, now we lift this cup.
우리가 마시는 이 잔을 통해 우리 안에 거하시는 주님, 주 안에서 ECFC 모든 교회와 지역이 하나 되게 하여 주시옵소서.
Through this cup we drink, we pray that in the Lord who dwells inside of us, all the churches in the region of ECFC become one.
지금 이 잔을 마실 때 주님의 손으로 우리를 만져주셔서 모든 약함과 질병에서 고침받게 하여 주시옵소서. 우리가 섬기는 교회와 각 지역의 땅에 고침받아 어둠의 영들을 물리치고 큰 부흥의 역사가 일어나게 하여 주시고 성령의 능력이 나타나는 보시게 가정이 되게 하여 주시옵소서.
When you drink this cup, you touch us in your hands, Lord, and we are healed from the weakness and disease. Also, the churches and the areas we are serving are healed, and the spirit of darkness are casted out. Spiritual revival rise up and spread out. The power of the Holy Spirit is manifested in the whole first-scale family.
우리 위에 피 흘리시고 그 손으로 치료하시는 예수님의 이름으로 기도합니다.
In Jesus' name, shed His blood for us. We pray. Amen.
Amen.
we want you to be with us. So, praise God. I want to thank the committee, the ECFC Executive Committee, for the work they did and for the work that we will do together as we take a look into the next ECFC. I'm sure you would want to know where we are planning to have our next ECFC. Should I tell?
Yes.
Yeah. The committee decided together unanimously to have it in Davao, Philippines. Woo! I have ulterior motives to go to sit in the Philippines because it's my second home, but all of you, I am sure, love to go to the Philippines. They are such a wonderful family, and they will do as well as the church in Malaysia has done. Thank you so much, and may the Lord bless you. And keep praying, keep moving forward, and also give all the support to our global prayer network coordinator. We all need to get our coordinators together from all the nations and regions, and fill the earth with prayer. Fill the earth with God's power through prayer. Thank you very much, and the Lord bless you.
All right. Amen. Praise the Lord. Once again, one last time, thank you so much, ECFC family, for coming to Malaysia. And thank you for giving us the honor of being your host. You have been the most incredible, incredible gathering of people. And we are so blessed, and we know that we're going to have a great time in Philippines. Philippines, are you ready?
Yeah. Okay, I would like to announce we will have our Southeast Asian second Women's Summit in Chiang Mai, Thailand, on October 2019. So we are inviting the ladies here, if you want to join us, you can join us. Next year, Chiang Mai, Thailand, October 2019. Okay.
And don't forget, Beyond Borders is in May 2019. All right. So get in touch with Joel or Asaf or Lemur. You can find them on Facebook. And you know, please bring your youth, please bring our young people. I think it was unanimous against yesterday, the day before yesterday, when we gathered as an ECFC committee, that all of us are going to get behind this youth gathering, because we've not had an ECFC youth gathering for a long time. So we have decided to ride on this bandwagon. Most of the nations are behind it, so please send your young people, get in touch with these guys so that you can send your young people to this convention. Why don't we sing and close this time in prayer, and then sing one song of praise as we depart from this place. God bless you, and we hope to see you real soon. Amen. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we just want to thank you. As we lift up our hands to you, we just want to give you praise, and we want to give you thanks for these wonderful days that we've had here, days of heaven on earth, Lord. And Lord, although we know that we would love these days to continue, we know that the real work is out there, Lord. And even as we get out there, Father God, Lord, we pray that you will just anoint our lips, anoint our hands. And Lord, we pray that you will just continue. Your presence will continue to go with us, Lord God. And there will be a great and fresh impartation. Every church, every nation, Lord, that we are going to go back to, Father. Lord, we just want to give you praise, and we want to give you thanks for all things. You're a great God, a great Father, a wonderful Savior. We give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. And all